हेलो गाइस, हेयर वी प्रोवाइड यू ऑडियो डिक्टेशन इन ओरिजिनल वॉइस ऑफ डॉक्टर जी डी विस्ट एट अ स्पीड ऑफ 100 बर्ड पर मिनट. इफ़ यू वांट मोर दीज टाइप डिक्टेशंस एट अ डिफरेंट स्पीड ऑफ ऑल बुक्स हिंदी और इंग्लिश देन सब्सक्राइब लाइक शेयर और कमेंट्स ऑल्सो ऑन माई चैनल. And lot of thanks of any kind of suggestion. Now ready?
Exercise 22. The appellant, along with six others, was prosecuted for commission of offences punishable under section 148 IPC. The appellant and other accused attacked D. Two of the accused gave lathi blows on his back, and as he fell down, the appellant gave a knife blow on left side of his chest. That accused R also gave knife blows to him. PW2 further stated that when he and his uncle tried to save D, accused R gave a knife blow on his left hand thumb, and two other accused gave him five lathi blows. His uncle was also stated to have received a lathi blow on his head. As to the cause of the incident, PW2 stated that as his other brother, PW6, who had been elected as village sarpanch, did not pay heed to unreasonable demands of accused persons, an altercation took place between both the sides the previous evening, but the matter was then patched up. The post-mortem examination of the body of D was conducted, and it indicates that one stab wound on the left side of the chest as the cause of death, and the three other injuries as post-mortem in nature. The trial court convicted and sentenced the appellant under section 302 and 324 IPC. Three other accused were convicted and sentenced under section 323(3) IPC. The remaining three were acquitted of all the charges. By a separate judgment, the appellant was also convicted under section 25 of the Arms Act and was sentenced to the period already undergone. The High Court upheld the judgments of the trial court. Aggrieved, the appellant filed criminal appeal challenging his conviction and sentence under section 302 and 324 IPC and criminal appeal number 132 of 2007 challenging his conviction under section 25 Arms Act. The trial court doubted the presence of PW4 and PW6 at the place of occurrence and did not accept their testimonies as eyewitnesses. According to the prosecution, the occurrence in which the deceased was killed took place shortly in the morning of June 24, 1995, when PW2 was medically examined with his companion, that is to say, within an hour.